Control. The picture search scans 10 times faster than normal speed. See? Perfect. And you can take it slow. Slower. Or stop it cold. Super video from JVC.
Tonight. It gave rain in the Midlands, then across East Anglia and the South East. It's moving away eastwards. Then these other fronts are fairly thin features until we get to that fella that'll probably bring some organised rain again late on tomorrow. The satellite picture shows both areas. They're just...
Next week, there'll be more about food when we visit a Chinese restaurant. And we'll also be looking at what happens when you have to phone work because you're sick. Meanwhile, if there are some things you'd like to go over in today's programme, you can get the Speak for Yourself book. It's on sale now at a bookshop near you.
Sunday, 9 till 2, late night, Tuesday and Thursday till 8.
Yes, yes! Sunday people!
Tomorrow, Big Mal's wife lifts the lid off their incredible marriage.
Malcolm has driven me wild. He's unbelievable. I've thumped him and locked him out. But I still love the guy. Sometimes we don't talk for days, so I've got to tell somebody what it's like. I'll tell you tomorrow.
Plus, did young Elvis have a harem and secret wives?
And what your name reveals about the real you.
In tomorrow's Sunday People.
Sunday People.
I'll never forget my first taste of Bailey's Original Irish Cream. The boys had been playing cricket, or was it golf? Anyway, Sarah, Mike, Tom and I were, I think, in the drawing room. But the moment was Bailey's. That delicious blend of Irish whiskey and dairy cream. Unforgettable. Actually, Tom wasn't there, but Brian was. And we might have been in the dining room.
Bailey's. Once tasted, never forgotten.
In the great Renault balloon race. Renault week starts May the 8th. So fly to your Renault dealer. Fly!
The people at Twydale asked me if I could pull a turkey out of this hat. It's only part of a hat, but they only wanted me to pull part of a turkey out of it. This is it. Twydale's Golden Roast. Prime turkey breast meat covered in a special recipe of golden roasting crumbs. Just unwrap it, pop it in the oven on a tray. Every slice is lean meat, so there's no waste. Golden Roast has all the flavour of a turkey feast in a 1¼-pound joint, but it's so inexpensive you can have another one whenever you want to. That's the magic of Twydale Golden Roast.
Next Tuesday at 7:30, the first TV showing of the...
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Tommy Cannon and Bobby Ball!
What I feel like. Mrs. Mortimer wanted to see me.
Yeah, she just popped upstairs. She'll be a minute.
Oh. Oh, well, in that case, I'll take the weight off my feet. What's it about, do you know?
Yes.
Oh. Good news or bad?
Let's just say things are a little tense.
Smile on your face. Hardly surprising since you managed to get yourselves a gold disc.
Silver, actually.
Sorry.
Jumping the gun a bit there. Silver, yes.
For what?
For the album, Duran. Available from all good record shops still.
And if all goes well, we'll be playing a single at the end of the show, yes?
I hope so, anyway, unless it rains.
What's your position is at the moment?
The album's number 6 and Girls on Film's number 15.
And Careless Memories got into the chart too.
Yes, it did.
As far as we're concerned, it did. So here it is. Let's see Duran Duran again, and this track called Careless Memories. Good memories of this track. Good track. Enjoyed this one. Did you?
Well,
you did it.
Bookshops, and the price is £2.75. There are also teacher's notes to accompany the series, which can be obtained free of charge by sending a 15.5p stamped addressed envelope, at least 12 inches by 9 inches, to Speak for Yourself, BBC Television, London, W12 8QT.
Oh, Nanu. Mark calling Orson. Come in, you cineraminous.
Just get on with your report, Mark.
Oh, yes, sir. This week, sir, I learned what it's like to be famous on Earth.
That's good.
Well, sir, sometimes it is and sometimes it isn't. You see, most Earthlings try very hard to be recognized for what they do, but when they become stars, sir, they realize they're recognized wherever they go.
You mean they lose their privacy?
Well, sir, sometimes they can even lose their clothes. You see, being a star, sir, is a 24-hour job, and you can't leave your face at the office.
Isn't fame its own reward?
Oh, yes, sir, it is. But when you're a celebrity, everybody wants a piece of you, sir. Unless you can say no, there'll be no pieces left for yourself.
I thought all stars were rich, live in mansions, and drive big eggs.
I know, sir, that's the common misconception.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Oh, Lucy, hold on. See if you can play this game, Humpty. Just, see if you can throw and catch a conker.
Try.
Oops. There you go.
Let me try. On the back of my... Oops!
With a totally tropical taste.
Refreshing.
With a totally tropical taste.
Pineapple and grapefruit.
There's danger on every road. You must stop at the curb. Only cross where you can see the road is clear. Keep looking and listening while you cross. Always use the green cross code.
Forget it.
Yes, most of us find them exasperating. But for anyone who's away from base a lot, telephone answering machines can be invaluable. And if they were cheaper and a bit more convenient to use, more people would decide to have them in their own homes. You'll notice that because Michael hung up so quickly, I've got to play through yards of tape to get to the next message.
Hello, Judith. Just to confirm, we are, after all, filming in Norwich on Tuesday. Bye!
Bye! The more expensive machines use two tape mechanisms. One is to carry my message, this is a telephone answering machine, etc., and the second tape records whoever's phoning in, although this class of machine will cost you around £130 or even more. A cheaper method is to use just one tape, like this. You record your bit, Judith Ham will be back in half an hour or whatever you want to say, at 30-second intervals all along the track. And then the incoming calls slot in to the 30-second pauses on the same track. But it's obviously extremely tedious when you have to record the same message 50 or 60 times. And it's even more tedious when you want to change that message. But it does bring the price down to about £100 in this case. Anything cheaper has got to be a lot simpler. And in fact, simplicity has been the approach of a British company, which decided to build a machine that only answers the phone. This doesn't listen. Now, that may sound ridiculous, but it's possible because this system, surprisingly and conveniently, uses your own tape recorder. It just plugs into the side of the machine, and any tape recorder will do, provided it has a remote stop-start socket. Right, I'll ring up the new machine and see what happens. Now, the electrical voltage on a telephone line is normally 50 volts, and that's shown here on the graph as a straight line. But as soon as I dial my number, once I've done that and it connects up, that voltage falls. And it falls quite dramatically to 10 volts. And straight away that tells the cassette on my answering machine to start answering.
is giving a Tomorrow's World demonstration at the moment. Would you leave your message now, please?
As soon as that stops, it turns on the tape recorder, which does mean there's another advantage. There's no 30-second fixed slot here, so the tape will continue to record until I hang up. A definite benefit when I consider the times that I've been cut off in mid-flow, because it always seems that my messages have to be more than half a minute long. When I put down this handset, the voltage on the post office line will drop right down to zero, like that, for just a moment. Then, solid-state logic in the new machine detects that zero and switches off my recorder. Watch. The tape's now ready for the next message, so there are no long pauses to wait through. All my messages are butted up neatly end to end. And that's something only the more expensive machines have been able to do in the past. But this new system, which is now waiting for post office approval, only costs £60. Mind you, if you've got to go out and buy a new tape recorder, it'll cost you more. But with a miniature one like this, there is another advantage. You can play back your phone messages conveniently wherever you are, perhaps in a traffic jam on the way home, or while you cook the evening meal, in the bath if that suits you.
In 10 minutes, Barry Took presents a look back at the pick of television highlights for 1981 to select that which achieved esteem, popularity or notoriety in the last 12 months. Pick of 81. But in less than 2 hours' time, it's the clock face of Big Ben that will hold our attention as we welcome in 1982, live from Trafalgar Square. Before that, though, we have the last main news programme on BBC One for 1981 with Richard Baker. It is 10 past 10.
The lifeboatmen of Mousel in Cornwall have refused to operate their new boat as anger...
...that accelerates faster from 0 to 60 than a Saab 900 GLS. That overtakes faster than a Mercedes 200. Yet costs less to buy than an equivalent escort saloon. And is styled in Turin by Ital Design. The new Maurice Ital, styled in Italy, built in Britain.
Pack it first. Poor Fred.
It's what getting wed does for you. Ruins your life.
Not getting wed doesn't do a lot for you either.
I say. And there he saw a lady bright. Or something like that.
Thank you, sir.
No pimps, no peel, no pimp, no powders, just juice. No oils, no acids, no preservatives, just juice. No sauce, no sugar, no corn, no coloring. Glucose, sucrose, and no dextrin. No flavoring, no stabilizing, just juice.
Does your orange have anything added, or is it just juice?
No additives, no mess, no fuss, just juice.
He'll be with you on the trip back.
Oh, but don't worry about being alone. We'll do everything we can to make it a fun cruise for you.
Who's worried? I've traveled all over the world alone. I went to China last year.
China? Wow, I'd love to hear about that.
Okay, if I find the spare time. But it looks like I'll be real busy. See ya.
Bye. He's cute, isn't he?
Yeah, too bad.
That's the Japanese totally supported entry that's leading us. In fact, there's more Japanese in the pit down there than there was in Okinawa in 1944. I feel a bit like John Wayne. I'm about to go over the top.
A complete and utter amateur nincompoop got in the way and turned right, just turned straight across my path, put me straight into the fence, and I took him, mate. That guy has to be Black Flag. I'm going to punch him in the mouth when the race is over, and that's a fact.
We're back on camera.
Saw a polar bear wearing a blank.
Give us a clue.
Huh?
Give us a clue.
Scott of the Antarctic. He's going the wrong way. He's just seen a polar bear wearing a blanket. Heavens above, do I have to explain everything to you, you foolish little man?
Yes.
Do I have to write everything out for you? Is it necessary for me to spell every single...
Talk to me like that, will you?
What?
Funny, it worked at rehearsal.
This show is totally unrehearsed. I wasn't expecting that.
Is it damaged?
Well, only a little.
Well, you can try this one. This works.
Does it? Mighty good, yes. Yeah.
It's fresh on loan from Lena Zavarone.
Oh, good. Can I use that? Scott of the Antarctic said it.
Reaching out in a piercing cry, it stays with you until
number two, Ron Haslam, the machine. He's running himself to get the fire extinguisher. That's a very expensive works Honda there. And the petrol tank almost full, of course. And they've got to get those flames out very quickly.
At 10 is Human League and Open Your Heart. At 9, the birdie song from The Tweets. At 8, Absolute Beginners, The Jam. At 7, Joan of Arc from Orchestral Maneuvers in the Dark. At 6, Goody Up the Roses, Elvis Costello. At 5, When She Was My Girl, The Four Tops. At 4, Label With Love from Squeeze. At 3, It's Every Little Thing She Does Is Magic, The Police. And at 2, Happy Birthday from Altered Images. And again at number 1, It's My Party, Stay Stewart and Barbara Gaskin.
Will he get it? Yes, he did. How are bombing along? 10 seconds of the game to go. And Arthur puts the whistle to his mouth. Rosby's round me, come on. Rosby's, come here, come on. The whistle, come here, let's have a look at you all.
And that brings us to the end of this Monday evening here on Granada, and we hope you've enjoyed your viewing. Have a good day tomorrow, when we hope you'll join us again. Now, with the time at very nearly 19 minutes to 1 o'clock, on behalf of everyone here at the studios in Manchester, this is Graham James wishing you a very good night. And may I just remind you to switch off the set. Good night again.